Hello everyone and welcome to Marg ERP video, in which our today's topic is that how you can export and import your accounts and inventory in the Marg software. This option of Marg ERP provides you the facility of exporting and importing your products or items, ledgers, vouchers, transactions of sale and purchase, etc. in any method. And here we would like to tell you that you can use this option of Marg only in Marg to Marg software. Means your data must be exported through the medium of Marg software and it must be imported in the Marg software only. So now let's come and see its process in the Marg software, for which you will firstly switch to that company of whose data you want to export. And in order to switch the company, firstly you will click on the exit tab given on the main window of the software and go to the list of companies window. From here, you will select that company of whose data you want to export and press enter. Then enter on Marg Gateway. Now from here, you will select that financial year and enter on it of whose data you want to export. So in this way, you will come to the selected company. Now you will go to Reports menu, then to Management Reports, then go to Utilities, and then from Data Import or Export, you will click on Account and Inventory Export option. Then this window of data export will open. In case if this kind of an alert message, sorry, you are not authorized to use this option, is shown to you, then you need to firstly go to the control room and enable this option. For which you will go to Masters menu, then to Marg Setups and click on control room. Then from here, click on search in all. Then in search field, you will type data export and click on accept button. And set this field, that is option of data export or import or both or not required as both from the drop down so that you can both export and import your data. Then press escape key twice and click on yes to the save changes window and go to the main window. Then by following the same location, you will go to data export window, in which firstly default path or location will be shown to you where your data will be exported. If you want, then you can change this path or location wherever and at whichever location you want to export your data. Then few fields will be shown to you. Let us understand these fields one by one, in which first is transfer. From here, you will select that the data which you are exporting, you want to do it with inventory or you want to export only the data of accounts. Then is bills up to. In this field, that date will be shown to you of which the last bill you have created in the software. In the same way, in last export field, the software will show you that date on which you have exported your data last time. And both of these fields will not be editable. These are shown here just for your knowledge. Then is export from. You will mention that date here from which date till which date you want to export the data. Then is selected party. If you want to export the data of some selected parties, then set this field to Y from the drop down and from the select party window. Select the ledger of the party or parties by pressing the spacebar key whose data you want to export. And by pressing enter, we will come back. Otherwise, keep this field as N, means keep it as no. Similarly, you will also do the selection of the company, means if you want to export the data of some selected companies, then set Y to the company field and select companies from the select company window. Otherwise, keep this field as N. And in this way, if you want to export data with opening balance, challan and vouchers that have been exported, then set these fields to Y. Otherwise, keep it as N. Then is freeze data after export. If you want to freeze the data once the data gets exported, means that if you want, there should not be any kind of changes or add-ons in it after data gets exported and that data should remain as it is. So you will set this freeze data after export field as Y. Otherwise, keep it as N. Then is series. If you want to export the transaction of any particular series, then you can mention that series here accordingly, which you want to export. Otherwise, you can skip this field. Then is transfer all or sales or purchase. You can select from here that you want to export all the transactions or of sales or purchase transactions you want to export or of inventory or of accounts transactions you want to export, so you can set it accordingly. Then after filling all the details, you will type transfer here and press enter. Then this pop-up message of data exported properly will be shown to you on your screen, and your data will get exported to the selected path or location. Now let's come and see how you can import the exported data in your other company, for which you will follow the same steps mentioned in the earlier process and will switch to that company in which you need to import the data. Then go to Reports menu, then to Management Report, then go to Utilities, and then from Data Import or Export option, you will click on Account and Inventory Import option. Then this window of data import will open, in which in the directory field, you will either paste that path where you have saved your data, which you are importing, or you will click on the directory button. Then this select window will open. From here, you will go to that location or path where the data is saved. Suppose our data is saved under reports in the Marg ERP folder in E drive. So by following the location, we will go to reports and from here click on OK. Now we will bring the cursor on that particular file or data and select the file or data. Then from here click on select. After this, the window of inventory and accounting import will open, in which in the data received from field, that path will be shown to you which you have selected now, and also become some more fields will be shown to you like receive opening and duplicate allowed, which you will keep it as it is, or you can set these fields as yes. Now we will keep them as N and then click on accept button. Then this window of data received from will open, in which the details like company name from which you are receiving the data, address of the company, company's short name means branch code, financial year, etc. will be shown to you. And your cursor will directly stop on show field. You can select from the drop down of show field that whether you want to import the unmatched data or all data. Now let us understand both the concepts one by one. So firstly, we will select all from the drop down of show field. And then in type sure field, you will type sure for the confirmation and then press enter. Then the process of data checking will get started. Now if your data which is being getting imported is correct, and if there are no type of errors or mismatch, then this kind of alert message, resaved successfully, no error found, will be shown to you. To which you will click on OK and proceed further. Then this window of importing will open, in which the software will ask you, delete import file, means you want to delete your import file or not. So you will keep this field as no and press enter. As you will press enter, the data will get imported and a message of data imported successfully will be shown to you. Now you can tally by going to your ledgers and item master whether the data has been successfully imported or not. Now let us come to the second method, in which if you want that the company whose data you are importing, the unmatched ledgers, items, etc. that exist in the number of ledgers, items, etc. must be shown to you, and you will import the data after matching them. So in this case, from the drop down of show field, you will set unmatched and type sure here. After typing sure, if there is any mismatch, then this kind of mapping window will be shown to you on the screen, in which whatever data is mismatched like ledgers, items, etc. will be shown to you. You have to simply match each ledger and item with your software ledgers and items by pressing enter key. And this is a one-time process. When you will import this company's data again in your company, then software will not ask you for mapping. So now let us come and see how you will map the mismatched data with the database of your software. Now, like for example, here ledgers of those parties are shown to you which are not mapped with the ledgers of your software. So for this, you will press enter on any party ledger. Then a window of created ledgers will open in your software. Now you will select that party's ledger by the name it has been created in your software. In case if the ledger of your selected party is not created in your software, so you will press F2 key or you will press shift and plus key together, through which you will see that the same ledger has been created. Now you will press Ctrl W key and will save the ledger. And you will press enter on the created ledger, so you will see that the ledger has been mapped. In this way, you will one by one map the ledgers shown on the screen with the ledgers of your software, and the ledgers which are not getting mapped with the ledgers created in your software. So for this, you will create and map them by following the same process. After the ledgers are mapped, press the escape key and click on the yes button given on save changes window to save the changes. Then the items which are mismatched will be shown to you. Here also you will follow the same steps and you will map the shown items with the items of your software. Then press escape key and click on yes to the save changes window. And as all the data will get matched, process of data importing will get also start. And again, this importing window of delete import file will open, to which from the drop down you will set as no and press enter. And once your data is imported, then this kind of an alert message, data imported properly, please run error checking, will be shown to you on your screen. Now by coming to the exit window, the company in which the data has been imported, press enter on it. And by clicking on error checkings and rewriting option, you will run the error checking so that the data which has been imported and the mapping of ledgers and the items which has been done should work properly. So friends, by following the process shown in the video, you can export and import the data of your accounts and inventory in the Marg software. Thanks for watching. Subscribe to Marg Tutorial YouTube channel and press this bell icon so you can stay updated with latest videos.